This morning, Bible reading is taken from books of Hebrew, chapter 1, verse 1 to 14. 希伯来书第一章第十四节，第一节，神借在故事借着众先的多次多方的效益列祖，就差这末世借着他儿子效益我们，又就以立他为全宙万有的，也前借着他创造诸世界，他是神荣耀所发的光辉。 是本体的真相，常用他全年的命令托住万有。他卸下了人的罪，就坐在高天至太子的右边。他所承受的名，也比天使的名更尊贵，就远超过天使。所有的天使，神从来对那一个说：“你是我的儿子。” 我今日生日，要知道那一个说，我要做他的父，他要做我的子。再者，神是长子来到世上的时候，就说神的使者都要拜他。论到使者，就说神以风为使者，以火焰为仆役。论到子，却说是那。 你的宝座是永永远远的，你的极权是正确的，你喜爱公义，恨恶罪恶，所以神就是你的神，用喜乐饶告你，胜过告你的同伴。又说：主啊，你起初立了天的根基，天也是你手所造的，天地都要灭没，你却要长存。 天地都要将衣服悄悄揪了，你要将天地建起来，像一根爱意，天地都改变了，唯有你永不改变。你的年岁没有穷尽，所有的天使神从来对那个说：“你坐在我的右边，定我使你朝天，作你的脚垫。”天使岂不都是？
富裕的人，奉差遣为那将要承受救恩的人效力吗？这是上帝的话，感谢上帝。Let
us pray.
让我们一起祷告。
Our gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word to us this morning.
所以天父们，感谢你的话语对我们说话。
We pray that Lord, your word will encourage us and strengthen us and continue to give us hope.
我们祈祷你的话语能够来继续的来坚强我们，让我们能够有希望。
We pray that your word will also guide us and lead us and also give us a foundation that we continue to hold on to your word as we walk in this earth.
我们求神你继续的以你的话语来扶持引导我们，好让我们能够以你的话语为根基，在这世上继续行走这个路程。
Open our hearts to receive and hear your word and to be doers of your word.
敞开我们的心来聆听你的话语，也能够成为来去行出你的话语。
May Holy Spirit grant us understanding of your word.
求你的圣灵来帮助我们能够明白神你的话语。
In Jesus' name we pray.
祷告奉耶稣基督的名字祷告。
Amen. I wish all of us a blessed Chinese New Year.
祝大家新年快乐。
Yeah, we're still in a very Chinese New Year mood, and surely, I believe even though it's the last day, I'm sure we will still continue this wonderful tradition of our Chinese culture.
我相信我们即使在新年的最后一天，我们还是会继续的来保持我们的新年的欢庆的这个美德。
And I'm sure in the last 14 days, we see a lot of people updating, whether it is in social media or in anywhere, a lot of things that is related to Chinese New Year.
我们看到就是在过去14天，不管是在我们社交媒体还是在哪里，他们都有在去跟进他们的状态，就是关于新年的。
And especially we see a lot of food being shared.
特别会看到很多的食物。
Being physically or even on the social media.
不管是实体的来分享，或者是在社交媒体上跟大家分享。
And we believe this is some of the tradition we hold on to as, you know, in the Chinese culture as we celebrate and we also remember God's goodness.
我想这是我们作为华人，我们就是有的一个习俗，也是我们能够去抓紧的一件事情。
Now, in the many things that we hold on to this morning, I want to encourage all of us also to go back to the very basics of our belief and our faith, that is to hold on to Jesus.
那不管我们抓紧的是什么东西，今天早上我希望能够帮助鼓励大家，就是再一次来抓紧耶稣。
Now, the last couple of weeks, we talk about breakthrough, and you are encouraged to, you know, to have a breakthrough, to step out, to experience, to anticipate a breakthrough in your life.
那在过去几星期，我们说到关于突破，我们说到就是要去跨出那一步，来去体验生命里面的突破。
And all the more, to have a breakthrough, we need to hold on to Jesus.
而要经历这样子的突破，我们更需要抓紧耶稣。
So that...we can experience that breakthrough and not experience a brokenness in our lives.
而我们能够经历到这个突破，而不是就是生命中的破碎。
Many times we want a breakthrough, but before we can experience the breakthrough, we are already broken.
很多时候我们希望有突破，但是在我们还没有经历突破之前呢，我们就已经被破碎了。
And we miss out what God has in store for us.
我们就错过了神为我们预备的。
And therefore this morning, even as we begin in the series of studying the book of Hebrews, it's very appropriate for us to look at this book and to study through how we can continue to hold on and to persevere in our faith.
所以今天早上当我们来看希伯来书的时候，很重要我们要来看要如何去抓紧，然后能够坚忍到底。
Because in this journey of life, we face challenges, we face obstacles, and all these can cause us to return back to our comfort zone.
因为在我们这生命的旅途中，我们会遇到很多的挑战，很多的拦阻，但是这一切都会让我们回到我们的舒适区去。
Now, the book of Hebrews is what we call a logical and yet a passionate book that rescue or encourage a group of persecuted Christians who at that point were thinking of going back to where they were before.
那希伯来书呢，就是关于一部就是怎么样去拯救，或者是去鼓励这一批被逼迫的基督徒，因为他们已经到面临要回到去他们之前的道路了。
And therefore, the writer writes in such a way to show that the superiority of Christ in a lot of areas.
因此，作者呢在写的时候，他就说了很多关于基督的超越性。
So we begin, if you see in this simple overview, that the superiority of Jesus, he is superior in his person.
让我们可以在这个纵览里面看到耶稣基督他的超越性。
That means he is superior than all the prophets, the angels, and even Moses.
首先就是他更优越的位格，就是他超越了这些先知、天使，甚至摩西。
And even superior than as our priests.
甚至比我们的牧师还要更高的位格。
Whether it is in the old covenant, the early priesthood, the Mosaic covenant system, and all the sacrifices, Jesus is superior than all this.
即使是旧约里面这个摩西的系统，或者是这些祭物，耶稣是比超乎这一切的。
And because of this, he is superior for our lives.
因此，他是在我们生命里面超越一切的。
That's why we are encouraged at the very end of this book that we have this faith to believe in God.
所以我们要鼓励透过这本书我们能够看到我们有信心的来相信神
to have the hope to endure the trials
有那个盼望来去面对这些的挑战
and to encourage one another
能够彼此的鼓励
So today is basically looking through an overview of this book how we can be encouraged to hold on to Jesus
所以今天我们要来看这一本书一个纵览好让我们能够看到我们要怎么样被鼓励来去抓紧耶稣
One of the things we can take home as an application from the study of the book of Hebrews is that despite all the challenges and the difficulties that may convince us to return to our norm or our previous way of life, it is to encourage us to embrace in that faith in Christ.
所以其中一个我们今天能够带回家的一个应用呢，就是即便我们遇到这些的困难和挑战，我们甚至已经濒临要回到去我们以往的生活的时候，我们能够被鼓励来去拥抱，就是跟随耶稣的这个道路。
And this book started off by assuring us that God has already spoken in the very, very beginning.
所以这本书开始的时候就已经让我们确信，就是说在一开始的时候，神已经说话了。
Hebrews 1 verse 1 to 2 says, In the past, God spoke to our ancestors through the prophets at many times and in various ways. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son.Whom he appointed heir of all things, and through whom also he made the universe.
在希伯来书一章一至二节这里说到，神迹在古时借着众先知多次多方的晓谕列祖，就在这末世借着他儿子晓谕我们，又早已立他为承受万有的，也曾借着他创造诸世界。
God has spoken in the past and in now, and even today, God still speaks.
神在过去、现在，甚至今天，他仍然在对我们说话。
So therefore, today we want to look at three areas how we could hold on to Jesus in our lives.
所以今天我们要从三个方面来看，我们要如何抓紧耶稣在我们生命里。
And by holding on, I trust and I pray that we all continue to experience that breakthrough in our lives.
而当我们抓紧耶稣的时候，我相信我也祷告，我们能够继续经历神这个突破。
Number one, we have to pay careful attention.
首先，我们要越发郑重。
Check your neighbor. Is your neighbor paying attention today?
看看你隔壁那个有没有专心今天。
Now, Hebrews chapter 2, verse 1 says that we must pay most careful attention, therefore, to what we have heard, so that we do not drift away.
所以在希伯来书二章一节这里说，所以我们当越发郑重所听见的道理，恐怕我们随流失去。
Now, bear in mind, the book of Hebrews is written to believers. It is to Christians. So therefore, the author is addressing this matter to the Christians that pay most careful attention, or else you will drift away.
所以我们要记得的是说，这个希伯来书是写给信徒的，是给基督徒的。因此，作者呢，他其实是要把这件事情带到这些信徒的眼中，就是知道我们必须要越发郑重的所听见的道理，否则我们将随流失去。
So to not only just pay careful attention by just hearing, but also doing it.
不只是听到，而是要行道。
Now, one of the things we all learned during the MCO is to read SOP, Standard Operating Procedures.
我们在这个整个行动管制令的期间呢，我们学习最厉害的事情就是要怎么样去看 SOP 这个标准作业流程。
And I believe all of us are expert by then.
我相信那个时候我们大家都是专业的了。
You can memorize almost
everything. 你可以背起来几乎所有的内容。
But do we do it accordingly? That's another thing.
但是我们是否有按照这个标准作业流程去做呢？那是另外一回事了。
But you and I know we have to pay attention to it, or else we get fined.
但是你和我都知道，我们必须要去留意，否则我们将会面临罚款。
But here in the scriptures, we have to pay most attention to the word, to God, so that we do not drift away.
但是在经文里面说的是，我们要越发郑重所听见的道，否则我们将随流失去。
Now to pay most careful attention, that is to also understand that at the end of the day, God is the builder of everything.
越发郑重的去所听见的道理，就是说我们要相信，我们要知道最终神是
God is the builder of everything.
神是建造一切的。
Now in Hebrews chapter 3 verse 4 says that for every house is built by someone.But God is the builder of everything.
在希伯来书三章四和六节说，因为房屋都必有人建造，但建造万物的是神。
Now, because God is the builder of everything, therefore we even more have to pay most careful attention to God.
因为神是建造万物的，所以我们更加要留意神所说的。
God is the builder of our house, of our home, of our family.
神是建造我们的房子，我们的家庭。
God is the builder of our life, our career, and even the ministry in the church.
我们的生命，我们的教会的事工，我们的事业都是神所建造的。
And therefore, all the more, we have to know and acknowledge this.
因此我们要有这样的认知。
Because when we do that, we will also make effort to enter that rest to pay attention to God.
因为当我们这样做的时候，我们将能够努力去接力进入这样的安息。
Remember, the book of Hebrews is written to Christians who are going through challenges and difficulties where they almost wanted to leave their faith and to go back as they were.
你还记得，就是希伯来书是写给这些信徒，这些信徒他面对的这些挑战跟面临的困难呢，是以至于他们愿意要濒临要放弃他们的信仰，回到他们以前的道路。
So the author is writing in such a way to help them to see that the reason you ought the more to hold on to Jesus because he's the builder of everything. And in order to do that, you need to pay attention and enter to that rest to pay attention.
所以作者如此写的时候，是让他们看见他们要抓紧耶稣的这个原因，更要抓紧耶稣的这个原因，因为神是创造要建造一切万有的。
Hebrews 4:11 says, Let us therefore make every effort to enter that rest so that no one will perish by following the example of disobedience.
在希伯来书4:11说，所以我们务必竭力进入那安息，免得有人学了不顺从而跌倒了。
Friends, the rest is there. God does not force it upon us. We have to enter to that rest.
朋友们，就是这个安息是在那里的，神并没有逼迫我们，强迫我们进入那个安息，但是我们必须要去竭力的进入那安息。
Your bedroom is there, your bed is there. You want to rest, you have to enter to your bedroom and lie down on your bed and rest.
你的房间是在那里的，你的床也在那里，但是你要休息的话，你必须得进入你的房间里面才能够休息。
You can't be say standing up here and say I'm having rest and I sleep unless you're really so gifted to sleep standing.
你不可能站在这个位置说，哦，我现在正在休息，所以我在睡觉，除非你真的是有这样的恩赐，能够站着睡觉。
I mean, I tried to learn it while we were studying because we were traveling in MRT and LRT. I tried to stand and sleep. I can't.
我曾经在读书的时期呢，就是尝试站着来睡觉，因为就是通勤的时候搭这个 MRT 跟 LRT, 但是我不行。
But I do notice some people can, interestingly.
但我发现有趣的是，有的人真的可以。
But for us to enter God's rest, we have to make effort to enter it. So that what? So that we will not perish by following the example of disobedience.
但是当我们要进入神的安息的时候，我们务必要竭力进去，免得我们学了不顺从而跌倒了。
Meaning to say that entering God's rest is basically coming to God,Hearing from God, engaging back with God, so that to continue to follow God's desire, God's heart, and God's purpose for us. What else, if we are not entering that rest, we are deprived, or even we are away from God's rest, it could lead to disobedience because we get ourselves further and further away from God.
意思就是说，当我们要来进入神的同在的时候呢，我们必须要有那个渴慕跟迫切，否则我们将会是就是因此而掉入这个不顺从里面。
We enter that rest so that we can receive and be recuperated by the word of God.
我们进入这样的安息，是好让我们能够领受，然后重新从神得力。
Yes, apart from that physical rest, we sleep and all that.But there's this spiritual rest. We need to be recharged through the Word of God and by being with God.
所以我们是可以透过就是休息睡觉，我们能够得到身体上面的这个休息。但是我们的属灵的休息呢，只是我们要透过神的话语来去花时间来去阅读神的话语，来得到神的安息。
And the author wrote to give confidence to the hearers that God's Word is so important and is alive and is active.
而这个作者在写的时候，他也特别要鼓励这些信徒，就是说神的话语是活泼的。
Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12 says, For the word of God is alive and active, sharper than any other double-edged sword. It penetrates even to dividing soul and spirit, joints and marrow. It judges the thoughts and the attitudes of the heart.
希伯来书4:12说，神的道是活泼的，是有功效的，比一切两刃的剑更快，甚至魂与灵、骨节与骨髓都能刺入、剖开，连心中的思念和主意都能辨明。
So my dear friends, to hold on to Jesus, firstly, pay careful attention.
所以我的弟兄姐妹，我们当要抓紧耶稣的时候，首先我们要越发郑重的留意。
Don't miss out what God has for you.
不要错过神要给你的。
Now, number two is to draw near to God.
第二就是要来到进到神面前。
Hebrews chapter 7 verse 19 says, For the law make nothing perfect, and a better hope is introduced by which we draw near to God.
希伯来书7:19这里说，法律原来一无所成，就引进了更美的指望，靠着指望我们便可以进到神面前。
Now at this point, it's basically telling us the law is not the prerequisite for salvation because we know Jesus is the one who saved. But the law points out the sin or point out the weakness of man. And therefore, the author says, the law made nothing perfect. The law does not save us.
那我们这里看到的就是律法并不是要得救的一个优先条例，因为耶稣是拯救的，而我们就是因此他说律法原来一无所成。
And we are saved, and as a result, we follow the law so that we continue to be righteous, and that's one of the key reasons, and not the other way around. That's why he says the law makes nothing perfect, but yet a better hope is introduced.
我们得救本乎我们跟随主，而不是因为律法的成全。所以他这里说，就引进了更美的指望，靠着指望，我们便可以进到神面前。
And when this hope is introduced, by which we draw near to God, and therefore we get to know this hope more and more.
当我们亲近神的时候，我们能够有这个希望。
And this hope is a firm and a secure hope.
而这盼望呢是坚固的。
Hebrews 6:19 says, "We have this hope as an anchor of the soul, firm and secure. It enters the inner sanctuary behind the curtain."
希伯来书6:19说，我们有这指望，如同灵魂的锚，又坚固又牢靠，进入幔子后面的至圣所。
Now the anchor was a common kind of a feature for hope in the ancient world.
那锚呢？它其实是一个盼望的一个形象，在古代的时候。
Perhaps today's too, because we use anchor in big ships.
那现在可能对我们来说也是这样，因为我们在造船的时候也有造锚。
We need the anchor to hold the ship and keep it from being wrecked.
我们需要这个锚来去使这个船能够安稳，不会被迫害。
Or even we need an anchor to stabilize the ship and make it more comfortable for those who are on board.
也甚至是要它来去让那个船更舒服、更平稳。
All right. But that anchor, if you know this, is let go to put underneath the water, and we won't see that anchor.
但是如果你知道的话，锚呢，基本上它是沉到水里面很深的海，我们基本上是看不到的。
We are anchored on something that is unseen, but yet that unseen thing is the thing that gives us hope, that has given us strength.
我们是被一个我们看不见的东西来去安，因此而感到安稳，就是。但是这样的看不见的反而是只给我们这个力量还有勇气。
For that reason, the author is saying that this is a better hope.
因此作者说这是更好的盼望指望。
He's encouraging them, hey, I know you are going through suffering, I know you are going through troubles and struggles. You are thinking of leaving your faith, but hey, this is a better hope coming.
他是说，哎，我知道你正在面临这个挑战，我知道你们在面临很多的不安稳，但是我甚至想要离开你的信，但是我们有更好的这个指望。
As believers, we are all very hopeful people. We are not hopeless.
作为信徒，我们每个人都是有指望的，我们不是没有盼望的。
And the scriptures today remind us, and we have this firm and secure hope, means this hope can never be shaken.
而今天的经文提醒我们，我们有坚固又牢靠的盼望。这意思是说，我们的盼望是不会动摇的。
And as we draw near to God with this hope, we are made holy through that one sacrifice.
而当我们以这样的信心来亲近神的时候，我们是透过神的牺牲能够得以成圣。
In Hebrews 10:10 says that, and by that will we have been made holy through the sacrifice of the body of Jesus Christ once for all.
希伯来书10:10这里说，我们凭着这旨意，借着耶稣基督，仅一次献上他的身体，就得以成圣了。
Now this being made holy is not that we are perfect, but we are being made set apart to the one sacrifice of Jesus Christ on the cross.
而这个得以成圣，并不是说我们是完美的，而是因为透过耶稣一次献上他的身体，我们能够被分别为圣。
We are set apart. We are different from the others.
我们是被分别为圣的，跟别人是不一样的。
And being set apart is being grounded in the work of Jesus Christ, and not just by what we do.
而分别为圣就是我们以神的话语为根基，而不是以我们的行为。
And therefore, when we come to know Christ, there should be that deep change in us that we are set apart.There is a difference, and therefore we normally encourage people to, to give a testimony of their life before they came to know Christ and after they know Christ.
那因此，当我们把我们的信心建立在主 基督里面的时候，我们是被分别为圣，我们被改变的。你记得我们以前就是会鼓励人，当他看他的生命在信主之前跟信主之后的差别吗？
So therefore, as we hold on to Jesus, we draw near to God. Keep drawing near to God, so that you continue to anchor in that firm and secure hope that we have, and we cannot be shaken.
因此，我们要当我们来抓紧耶稣的时候，我们要更加进到神的面前，亲近神，好让我们这个坚固又牢靠的盼望，我们不会动摇。
Not only that, we are not so easily being shaken. We are not so easily being stumbled.
不只是不会那么容易动摇，我们也不会被绊倒。
No, we are very aware and very conscious that no, we don't want to stumble others.
我们很清楚，不要成为别人的绊脚石。
It's a good thing. It's a concern. It's something that we need to be aware of.
是很好的，是我们必须要关注的，我们要理解的。
But as Christians, as believers, we should not be that easily stumbled too if we have that strong and firm anchor that we are holding on.
但是作为基督徒，我们也不应该这么容易被绊倒，因为我们有坚固的锚。
Right? In festive season, we have so many cultures, not only the Chinese, but the Malay and other tribes. So we have a lot of cultures. So we say that we have to be very careful, be mindful, so that we don't stumble others. Yes, we don't stumble others, but among us as believers, we should not be that easily being stumbled.
那在这些家庆的节日里面呢，我们有可能马来人，我们有华人，每个人有不同的这些庆祝的风俗。但是作为基督徒，我们也很常说，我们不要去绊倒别人。可是同时，我们也要抓紧神的话。
If we are that easily being stumbled, then there's no more angbao giving during Chinese New Year.
如果我们那么容易被绊倒的话，那可能新年我们就不会再给红包了。
But we know that that's something good because it's also biblical, right? To be a blessing, to give, and all that.
但是我们也知道这是正确的，因为我们也是要像圣经说的，要去来祝福别人。
But therefore, as we draw near to God, we are being set apart. We have this hope, and therefore we can continue to hold on to Jesus.
但是当我们亲近神的时候呢，我们是被分别为圣的，我们有这个盼望，因此我们能够抓紧耶稣。
Now to hold on to Jesus, thirdly, is to throw off everything that hinders.
而第三就是我们要来放下各种重担。
Hebrews chapter 12 verse 1 says, Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles.And let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us.
希伯来书十二章一节这里说，我们既有这许多的见证人，如同云彩围绕着我们，就当放下各样的重担，脱去容易缠累我们的罪，存心忍耐，奔那摆在我们前头的路程。
Now the author here is describing that in the previous chapter 11, you know that chapter 11 of Hebrews is the hall of faith, where the list of the people of faith. So he's basically saying,This cloud of witnesses, those who are faith heroes, they are there. We are all surrounded by all these heroes. So therefore, we need to throw off everything that hinders, then entangles, and run with perseverance.
那作者在写的时候呢，他是指着第十一章说的，就是第十一章。如果你知道希伯来书十一章是关于这些信心伟人的一个清单、一个名单，那我们可以看到，就是说这些信心的伟人，他们就好像是英雄那样，他们在做我们许多人的见证，如同云彩一样围绕我们。因此，我们要脱去缠累我们的罪，来去奔走这个路程。
It is like a runner running in a stadium. If the runner is running in an empty stadium, competing among the other runners and the stadium is empty, they will just run for the sake of the competition.
那就好像一个在跑步的人，当他在一个空的广场里面跑的时候呢，他其实就好像只是在怎么样？
Just competing, running among themselves.
就是他们彼此在跑比赛而已。
Right? But when your stadium is full of supporters and they're competing and when as they run,Each and every one of them has their own supporters and cheering them on. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So they run with even more enthusiasm and with more energy.
但是如果他们在这个在奔跑的时候，有人在支持他们，在鼓励他们跑啊，加油啊，那他们可能会跑得更加热忱。
Even the person, the runner may be on the last place, but because of people cheering the runner, that runner can catch up and win.That whole race.
即使那个人在跑的时候，他可能是最后一位，因为有人鼓励他，他就可能跑到第一位，然后甚至赢了这个比赛。
Now this is what the author of Hebrews is saying to the believers then, that we have this surrounded by this cloud of witnesses. They are cheering us on. What we need to do is to throw off everything that hinders and the sin
that so easily entangles.
所以这就是作者在鼓励这一群基督徒，就是说我们已经有这些信心的伟人，他们是我们的见证人，如同云彩围绕我们，所以我们应该要脱去这些缠累我们的罪和重担，然后奔走前面的事程。
It takes effort to throw off something.
要抛弃一些东西是需要力气的。
You don't just simply just throw something, but it takes effort.
你不只是随便的抛弃一个东西，是需要付出的。
In the course of serving the Lord with the various transfer I've experienced, it really takes efforts. Why? We take effort to pack and move, but as I pack, it takes effort to throw.
在服侍神的这个道路上，我们有很多的这个搬迁的时候呢，其实除了要去收拾东西、收拾行囊以外，我们也需要扔掉一些东西。
Because there are those things that is to be moved, shift. There are those things that need to be thrown away. So I have to put all those things into my car and bring to where it's supposed to be thrown and throw it away. If I just leave them there in my home, it will just be piled up and piling up again and again.
因为要搬家的时候，有些东西是要搬走的嘛，有些东西是要扔掉的。那要扔掉的，我必须要去收拾好，放到我车子里面，送到去该扔的地方。如果我只是把它留在家里的话，它就是一直在那边堆积。
Here in this verse, we know, yes, the sin will entangle us. But there are times it also refers to what we do, something that may hinder us from really growing or something that may hinder us from walking with God.
这里有看到的是缠累我们的是罪，但是有时候是一些我们做的事情正在让我们觉得很疲惫要走这段路。
Maybe something that is not rather or whether it is right or wrong, but it's just that something thathinders you, that blocks you. Like we say in the IT, you say there's a firewall that blocked you from entering.
那就是或许它只是在阻碍你，如果我们在就是电脑的说法，就是说有个防火墙在阻拦你。
So as we continue to walk, we cannot carry those things that hinder us. We say baggages in our lives that hinder us from continue to walk with God.
因此当我们跟随主的脚踪在行走的时候，我们不能够抱着这些的包袱，生命中的包袱来走。
Now imagine this, we say we walk with God means that we walk together. Yes, God walk with us as well. We walk together with God.
想象这样，当我们说我们跟神一起跟随神的脚踪的时候，我们是跟神一起的走。
But imagine like today, okay? Just imagine for a moment that Michelle is God, I'm walking with God.
那想象一下，如果牧师是神，然后我跟着牧师走。
That's not literal translation. Okay? So, God is walking and said, I want to walk with God, but then, I want to carry this together with me.
那比方说当我要走的时候我要走，但是我要撑一个东西跟着我走。
This one still looks very like I can still walk together.
这看起来还是很轻，我还是可以跟着神走。
Okay, 你试着走啊 okay? Okay, okay. Stop. I have to catch up. And then I say, I want to walk with God, but I want to carry more things with me.
但是我说我要跟随神，但是我还要再拿更重的东西，更多的东西。
And God keep walking, and I try to walk. And I will begin to say, God, don't walk so fast, okay?
那神继续走，然后我跟着走的时候，我会说，哎，神啊，你不要走那么快。
Sometimes these are the things that we may hold on to much that we can't walk.With God.
有时候因为这些东西我们抓紧的太多，以至于我们没有办法跟随神走。
So therefore, why Hebrews here says that need to throw off everything, not only something, but everything that hinders.
因此在这里希伯来书说我们必须要放下各样的重担，不是一些重担，而是各样的重担。
Why? Because there is this race that has already marked out for us. There's this race that's prepared for us.We need to run this race with perseverance.
为什么呢？因为这有一个有一个赛程是需要我们去奔跑的，是我们必须要去经历的，而我们必须要有坚韧来去奔跑这个。
So as we throw off all these things, as we go through, as we hold on to Jesus, we be reminded of there's this one thing also we need to be mindful of. That is, we need to endure the hardship.
所以当我们抓紧耶稣，我们放下各样的重担的时候，我们必须要记得有一件事我们需要做，就是我们要忍受困难。
Now, being a believer is not a bed of roses.
那成为基督徒并不表示你的生命是一帆风顺的。
Even you put a bed with full of roses, roses have thorns.
就是在英文里面有个俚语是说生命不是很像一床这个玫瑰 即便是玫瑰也会有刺。
Unless it's just the rose itself, not the whole stick, right? But let's say if the whole stick, you still have thorns and you lie down on it, you still feel the pain.
就是如果你把这个床铺满了这个玫瑰，然后当然它有那个刺嘛，对不对？你躺下去，你还是会被刺伤的。
Because we say we want to follow the footsteps of Jesus, so think along with me, what did Jesus experience and encounter?
所以我们说我们要跟随耶稣的脚踪，那你想一下，就是耶稣他经历了什么呢？
He went through betrayal, suffering, pain.
背叛、痛苦，还有这个受困难。
So if we are going through it, praise the Lord because you are walking and experiencing what Jesus has encountered.
所以当你经历这一切的时候，要赞美神，要感谢神，因为你在经历神耶稣所经历的。
But we know it's not easy when we're going through tough times and we say thank God for these hard times. It's very difficult. It's most likely, most of the time is after that.
但是要在困难的时候来说啊，主啊，我感谢你，因为我有这样的困难，其实是有点难的。就是通常是结束了之后，我们说啊，感谢神。
I know. I went through an appendix operation when I was in the secondary school. I cannot be saying that thank God for this operation, but then I was still in pain.
我知道的，因为就是在中学的时候呢，我做了这个盲肠炎的手术，所以我不可能在我疼痛的时候跟神说神啊，我感谢你，因为有疼痛。
And in those days without handphone, I have to with mad pain, bearing that pain, walk to the public phone. If you know, still know what is public phone, okay, and get.And borrow from the nurse 10 cents to call my parents to pick me up from the hospital, enduring that pain.
而那个时候呢是没有手机的，就是我需要走到忍受这个疼痛，走到去那个公共电话亭。如果你知道什么是公共电话亭的话，我还要跟那个护士小姐借一毛钱来打电话叫我的父母来医院载我。
Because I can be discharged, I'm very happy.
因为那时候我可以出院了，我很高兴。
But in the midst of happiness, I still endure pain.
但是在高兴的过程中，我还是忍受着痛苦。
And in that pain, I cannot say, "Wow, praise the Lord! I can give this opportunity to endure this pain, to walk to the phone booth and to call my parents." Wow, hallelujah! Thank God for this pain. At that moment, I can't.
但是当下就是我疼痛的时候，我没有办法一边走，然后忍着疼痛，还要说，感谢主，我能够出院，我这个疼痛，我感谢主。
But now, as I share with you, I say, praise the Lord for that experience.
但是现在我跟你分享的时候，我说，感谢主，我有这样的经历。
I understand what it means to endure pain.
让我能够明白什么叫做要忍受疼痛。
But here the scripture says endure hardship.
但是经文说要忍受困难。
Hebrews 12:7 says endure hardship as discipline. God is treating you as his children. For what children are not disciplined by their father?
为了这里希伯来书十二章七节说，为了受管教，你们要忍受。神待你们如待儿女，哪有儿女不被父亲管教的呢？
As we run this race that is marked out for us, the author is basically saying that there will be challenges, and here he says there is hardship, and we need to endure it.
而当我们在奔走这个道路的时候，我们作者让我们知道很清楚，知道我们有挑战，而我们在面对这些困难跟挑战的时候，他鼓励我们就是要去忍受这样的困难。
And hardship is a discipline that God used to discipline us.
困难呢是神用来管教我们的方法。
Now we look at the word discipline in a very negative sense. It's like we all related to school, right? Discipline.
那当我们说到管教的时候，纪律的时候，我们想到的就是很负面的。我们想到的是很像在学校里面说的这些纪律。
So when we think about, wow, God disciplined me, it means I've done something wrong. God disciplined me.
而我们说到神管教我们的时候，一定是我做错了什么，神要管教我。
And that's why there are times we think that, oh, because this morning I didn't read the Bible, I suddenly fall down and knock my head up. Wow, God punish me, God discipline me.
甚至有时候我们会觉得，因为今天早上我没有读我的经文，所以我跌倒了，摔伤头脑袋，是上帝在管教我，在处罚我。
That makes us no difference from a pagan who think that, no, we have to do something to get something from God.
这让我们跟非信徒，就是说我们需要靠着行为来去得到神给我们一些东西是不一样的。
Now, when God discipline, it's not to the sense of punishment, but it is to make right and to train us to be better.
而当神来管教我们的时候呢，并不是要来去处罚我们，而是要帮助我们做对的事情。
Now, hardship in this context, it's not punishment. It is God molding us to be better.
而这里的困难并不是一个处罚，而是神塑造我们来成为更好的。
And therefore, we need to endure it so that what? So that we become better.
因此我们要忍受它，好让我们能够成为更好的。
And that is where, as we persevere to run this race marked out for us, we need to endure.
因此我们在奔走这个为我们预备的这个路程的时候呢，我们必须要忍受得住。
And we talk about throw out some things, throw off everything that hinders. That's one of these things is to learn to be content.
而当我们说放下各样重担的时候呢，有一件事情我们需要学习的，就是要学习知足。
Sometimes the things that hinder us, perhaps there are the many, many things that is in our lives where we are not content. We want more and more.
很多时候，其实，在我们的生命里面，我们会觉得我们不够，我们想要更多、更多，我们永远不满足。
Now Hebrews 13 verse 5 says, "Keep your lives free from the love of money, and be content with what you have, because God has said, 'Never will I leave you, never will I forsake you.'"
希伯来书十三章五节说，不可贪爱钱财，要以自己所有的为满足，因为神曾说，我绝不撇下你，也绝不丢弃你。
Now money is not evil because we all need it for survival.
钱不是邪恶的，因为我们需要钱来生存。
But the scriptures here says that keep our lives free from the love of money and be content with what you have.
但是经文说不可贪爱钱财，要以自己所有的为满足。
Be content what we have is what we have. Be thankful and say thank God I have. Because a lot of times we look at what we do not have and complain about it.
以自己所有的为满足，就是说，因为我有这些东西，我觉得满足了。很多时候，我们看到我们有的，我们觉得不满足。
We may first start off to complain by saying, "I do not have a car."
有时候我们可能开始投诉说，哦，我没有一部车子。
Then you bought a Cancio. You say, "Yes, I have a car."
然后你就买了一个 Cancio， 然后你说，哦，我有部车子了。
But then too small. I want a MyV.
但是太小了，我想要一部 MyV。
So you get a MyV and sell off your Cancio.
然后你就因为有了这架 MyV， 你就卖了你的 Cancio.
Then you have already your MyV and say, no, I want slightly bigger car. Okay, you go for a 7-seater. You go for Alza. Sorry, I go for Malaysia brand. Okay.
然后你本来从MyV， 你觉得哎呀我还是不够，我觉得我要多一点座位的，那你就去找一个七个人可以坐的车，你去买 Alza.
Okay, you say Alza, No lah, it's big lah, it's nice lah, not so powerful ah.
然后你觉得，哎呀，奥赛其实挺大的，挺漂亮，但是好像不怎么够力。
Then you want to change again, and it never ends.
然后你就想要去换，然后这样的情况是一直下去没有改变，没有进止。
If the Lord bless you, it's okay to change car, please. Okay, it's okay. Right? Tell your friend it's okay. It's
如果上帝祝福你的话
，Some of you have changed cars, it's okay.
如果上帝祝福你的话，没有问题的，要换车是没事，跟你隔壁说没问题的。
Okay.I also changed, okay, after more than 15, 17 years of my cars, all right?
我也会换车的。
But again, it's our heart. Are we content with what we have?
但是再一次要说明的就是我们的心，我们是否对于我们所拥有的感到满足呢？
It is many times that discontentment could be the things that hinder us from running this race that God has marked for us.
很多的时候这样的不满足是阻碍我们，拦住我们来去奔走这个道路的。
We pray God give me 5,000 and God give you 5,000 and then you get the 5,000 you think God can give more or not? Actually, I want to do some saving.
那比方说你祷告，神啊，给我5,000块，然后神给了你5,000块，然后你说，哎，神啊，可以再给我多一点吗？因为我想要存款。
So be content, my dear friends.
所以我们要学会满足啊，弟兄姐妹。
So throw off everything that hinders us, so that we can.Run this race that is marked out for us, and that's why hold on to Jesus.
所以我们要放下各样的重担，好让我们能够奔走这个为我们预备的道路，来抓紧耶稣。
It may be easy for us to say just hold on to Jesus, trust God, but when you are in a real situation, sometimes you really struggle.
有时候要说要抓紧耶稣，信靠神是很容易的，但是真正要去这么做的时候是很困难的。
I can only say this, my dear friends, that God never fails us. As the verses now say, God never leave you or never forsake you.
但是朋友们，我要鼓励你的就是说，神 永远不会撇下我们，也不会丢弃我们。
I was used to told that when I serve the Lord that you won't get much.
我很常当以前我在服事的时候，人家说当你服事神的时候，你不会得到太多。
And my especially my parents were very concerned that how would you survive?
特别是我的父母会非常担心，哎，你要怎么样生存啊？
Right, and think again, okay, whether you are really wanting to serve.
你要不要认真再考虑一下要服事神这件事情？
But because of God's call and the clarity of God's call in my life, that I keep and hold on to that call.
但是因为神的呼召，还有我很清晰知道神的呼召当下，所以我抓紧。
Yes, I may not have that kind of luxurious life, maybe as some of my friends or some of my peers, but I have not fall short.
是的，我或许没有像我朋友那样过一个很奢华的生活，但是我并没有缺乏什么。
Yeah, maybe some of them by the age of 30, they already are big businessmen and doing very well and all that. But hey, I'm not too bad. By the age of 30, I drive different cars and different vans because I serve in the church.
那或许他们30岁的时候就成为很就是事业有成的这些生意人。但是我30岁也不差，我开过很多的车子，开过很多的这些van。
福音车，我驾着福音车，不同牌子的福音车。And there's one van I drive is Mercedes Benz. It's okay, I never drive a real Mercedes Benz. I drive a van that is.The brand is Mercedes-Benz. Not bad, right? I drive Benz, 吗？
甚至有其中一个福音车的牌子是奔驰。即便不没有开过真的奔驰车，但是哎，那个也是奔驰的福音车。
My friend have big houses to stay and everything. I said it's okay. I moved to different houses, from double story to apartments to double story to apartments.
So okay, right? 我朋友有很大的房子住，但是没关系啊。我也有住过很多不同的房子，从双层楼的去这些就是公寓等等。
So sometimes I go to travel for equipping or training. The organizer put us sometimes a very very good hotel. So I say, hey, not bad, right? Okay, right?
甚至有时候我去训练或者是去参加一些课程之类的，他们都会主办单位给我们很好的这些饭店居住。哎，那也很不错啊。
I remember once in Korea, one of the church put us to stay almost like a president's suit. I said, I only one person, why I need two queen size bed?
甚至有一次，我记得我在韩国的时候呢，他们几乎是给我安排了一个好像总统套房那样。我说我只有一个人，为什么要给我两个 queen size 床？
I stay one night only. I can only enjoy one night of queen size bed. If two nights, of course, I can change to the other side.
我只住一个晚上，我只能够享受一个那个床。但是如果我住两个晚上，我还可以试试另外一张床。
I was thinking, should I divide my sleeping hours half here?
我还在想，我是不是要分开一半一半的睡眠时间？
But then, because of all this, I learned also to be content. I learned it's okay not to have.
但是因为这一切，我学习就是要来知足，就是没有关系。如果我没有这些
，I'm okay to just sleep in the floor. As long as I get to sleep, lah, it's okay.
即便是要躺在地上睡，我也觉得没问题。只要我能够可以睡觉就好了。
So if there are things that I know that will hinder me, I better be aware of it and throw it off.
如果我知道有什么东西是会阻拦我的，我要有意识的要把它抛开。
I rather not have a room with two queen size bed and then affect my walk with the Lord.
我宁可不要有一个有两张 queen size 床的房间，如果它是会影响我跟水城的这个道路。
So that's why the author ofHebrews encouraging the believers at that time, hey, Jesus is superior than all these things, and that is that reason why you need to hold on to Jesus.
因此，希伯来书的这个作者他在鼓励那时候的信徒，就是说，嘿，耶稣他是超越这一切的事情，所以你要抓紧耶稣。
Hebrews 13 verse 20-21, as the book concludes, it says that now may the God of peace.Who through the blood of the eternal covenant brought back from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, that great shepherd of the sheep, equip you with everything good for doing his will, and may he work in us that is what is pleasing to him, to Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever and ever. Amen.
在希伯来书十三章二十到二十一节，这里说：但愿赐平安的神，就是那凭永约的之血使群羊的大牧人，我主耶稣从死里复活的神，在各样善事上成全你们，叫你们遵行他的旨意，又借着耶稣基督在你们心里行他所喜悦的事，愿荣耀归给他，直到永永远远。Amen.
So the author conclude by giving us an understanding of who this God is. Right? That God, yes, that sent Jesus Christ to earth to save us, but this God is also the God of peace.
所以作者他是以让我们看见就是这个神是怎么样的神，他 是平安的神，他也是拯救我们的神。
And his God is that great shepherd of the sheep, equip you with everything good for doing his will.
是群羊的大牧人在各样善事上成全我们。
Now God is our great shepherd, not just as to lead us, to protect us, but here we see that great shepherd of the sheep will equip us with everything good to do what? To do God's will.
神是我们的大牧人，他不只是要善待我们，而是要帮助我们，让我们在各样的善事上成全我们，来遵行他的旨意。
And all the more we go back and hold on to this God of peace.This great shepherd that will train us, because that's where we get our training and equipping.
因此，我们更 great shepherd. 更应该的去抓紧这个训练我们来去赐我们平安的神。
So my friends, this morning, I do not know what we go through in lives. God knows.
所以弟兄姐妹，我不知道今天你在生命中经历些什么，神知道。
What is your struggles?
你的挣扎是什么
？What is your obstacle?
你面对的困难是什么
？Maybe you are going through perhaps a very difficult stage of life. Your emotion, your physical, your mental, everything. You say that, wow, this is a difficult year, even though it's a Chinese New Year.
或许你在经历这样身心灵的这些困难和挑战和挣扎，你说，哎呀，即便是新年，我觉得这是一个非常困难的年。
Some of us may ask why.I have to go through all this.
有些人或许会问，为什么我需要经历这一切？
In the course of my life, I asked a lot of whys, and I have made a conclusion that if I can't figure it out, it must be from God. Because the scripture says, His ways, His thoughts are higher than mine.
在我生命中，我很常无数次的会问神啊，为什么？而我渐渐的得到一个总结，就是当我找不到为什么的时候，这一定是来自于神，因为神的道路，圣经文说，神的道路比我们的还要高。
And sometimes there are no answers. I have no answers. I can't answer. If people come and ask me, know why, Pastor, I go through this, and I say I cannot answer. I cannot say much. I cannot say even I understand because sometimes maybe I really don't understand what you go through.
甚至有时候，很多时候，当人跟我说啊，传的牧师，为什么我会经历这一些？我也不能够说哦，我理解，因为我有时候真的不理解为什么你要经历这一切。
But there's one thing I'm very, very sure.
但是有一件事我非常的肯定。
God is always there.
神永远都在。
God is always there.
神永远都在。
Even though sometimes I feel that God is not there, but God is still there.
即使有时候我觉得神不在那里，但是神依然在那里。
Even though there are times I feel that everything perhaps must be maybe against me, but God is still there, very miraculously.
即使有时候我觉得为什么整个世界都好像与我为敌的时候，但是神很神奇的仍然在。
And therefore I resolve not to lose sight of God.
因此我决定不要就是把焦点从神上转移。
Like in one of the verses in the book of Hebrews, even as we study along the weeks, one of the verses in the book of Hebrews says what? It's chapter 12, verse 1, verse 2 actually. In short, fix your eyes on Jesus.
而其中一个在希伯来书十二章第二节说到，就是当专注仰望耶稣。
So I'll tell myself, whatever goes through in life,I will fix my eyes on Jesus.
所以我跟我自己说，不论我经历什么样的事情，我要专注仰望神耶稣。
And friends, this brings us back to something that is very, very basic, but yet very, very precious in our walk with Christ.
因此，朋友们，这个是让我们回到最基础、很重要的一件事情，在我们跟随神的时候。
That is our time with God.
就是我们跟神之间的时间。
How many of us still make time to spend with God?
我们到底有没有花时间来去与神同行呢？
I find out that the more challenges, struggles, whatever I go through, I find that time with God becomes so much more precious.
而我发现就是当我面对更多的挑战、更多的困难的时候，跟神同在的这个时间是更加的珍贵。
Because that is where I keep holding on to my God.
因为那是我继续更加的坚持的抓紧我的神 的时候。
So I want to leave this with you this morning, even as we respond to the word. Yes, we hold on to Jesus.
所以今天当我们来回应神的话语的时候，我要让大家有这样想法，就是是的，我们来抓紧耶稣。
Make that time with God, so that you can hold on to Him.
但是我们依然要花时间跟神独处，就是好让我们能够来抓紧神。
Let us pray.
让我们一起祷告。
Before we pray, I want to just give us this short moment to just allow God to speak to you.
在我们祷告之前，我想要给大家一点时间来让神对你说话。
What's in your heart? What's in your mind? Let God speak to you in these next few seconds.
在你的心里，在你的脑海里，让神来对你说话。
Even for those who may be watching online, God can still reach out to you. God can still speak and touch you wherever you are.
即使你是在线上跟我们一起崇拜的，无论你在哪里，神仍然能够对你说话，来去触摸你。
Father, we thank you that you are our amazing God.
父神，我们谢谢你，因为你是我们奇妙的主。
You are our unchanging God.
你是我们不改变的主。
And you are our great shepherd.
你是我们的大牧人。
We thank you that God, you are always there, never leave us nor forsake us.
我们谢谢你，因为你一直都在，你永不撇弃我们，也不丢弃我们。
Father, I pray this morning, whatever we are going through,I pray that Father Lord, we will fix our eyes on you and hold on to Jesus.
主啊，无论今天早上我们在经历什么事情，帮助我们能够专注仰望神，来抓紧耶稣。
That we continue to trust in you.
让我们继续的信靠你。
We continue to pay most careful attention to your word.
我们继续留意、留心你的话语。
To draw near to you.
来亲近你。
To throw off everything that hinders our race, our walk with you.
来抛开各样拦阻我们来奔走这个跟你一起的路程。
So Father, even as we draw near to you this point of time, Father, I pray that you touch us, you minister to us wherever we are sitting and wherever we are watching, because God, you are there, you are here.
主啊，今天当我们来去仰望神你的时候，主啊，不论我们在哪里，求神你来触摸我们，对我们说话。
Touch us, Lord, this morning.
触摸我们，神。
Thank you, Lord.
感谢耶稣。